Friday morning. Crystal Porter looks to attack. Weaves inside for an uncontested layup, 2-0 Canisius. Tried pick and roll, now left alone. She'll take that shot. Nothing but net. Margaret Halfdan, our daughter. Miskovic in the front court. Spins into the paint. Miskovic back out to Cooley. Open from three. Nothing but net for Sarah Cooley. Inside to Schuwen. Diagonal pass out to Mann. She'll take the open three, and she knocks it down. Back out to Halfdan, our daughter. Tough pass. Welch gets it back. Looks to go baseline. Gets inside. Layup good. Maria Welch.
Good shot, but not that time.
Strautmane. Nice pass to McClure. 17-footer. Nothing but net for Aryn McClure. The freshman inside to McClure. Against Welch. Freshman against freshman. McClure goes up and finishes, and we're tied at 12. Miskovic now has it. Inside and then back out to DeHaan. Her three. Nothing but net for Lauren DeHaan. Grips back in the lead by three. Short, no good. Rebound tapped around. Pulled away by Sarah Cooley, and here come the Griffs. They have numbers. DeHaan in the front court. Nice pass to Welch. Her finish is good, and the Griffs back up by five.
You see the fire.
Two key players out with injuries already. Manns, she'll take the three, and she knocks that down. Morgan Manns, 40% three-point shooter, good there, and it's a two-point Canisius lead. Henrik's daughter tries to go baseline. Her pull-up, counted, and it goes, and it does. Sarah, Henrik's daughter, with an opportunity for a three-point. Stops her dribble. Finds the cutter. Henrik's daughter goes to the rack with the left hand and finishes. Back to Johnson. McClure, they swing it back out. Open three, and knocking that down is Strautmane. Paula Strautmane, 33% three-point shooter. Porter, cross court. Halfdan, our daughter. Her three. Nothing but net. Margaret Halfdan, our daughter.
She was on my team, and I didn't have to go up against her.
Strautmane, her three, knocks it down, and we're tied again for the third time this afternoon. In the low block to Johnson. Thought about the jump shot, now back out. Napolitano knocks down the three. Maria Napolitano, 29% from behind the arc. Good on that one, and it's a one-point game. McClure being harassed by Miskovic. McClure looks to drive and finishes with the left hand, and we're tied again for the third time this afternoon. Porter back inside to Porter. Turnaround shot, nothing but net for Crystal Porter. Porter again. Porter against Strautmane. Finds the cutter, DeHaan, and she lays it up and in. Canisius the biggest lead of the afternoon. Now looks to step back with six to shoot. Cross court pass Fabry, here three. Nothing but net for the coach's daughter. McClure pulls up from 10. No good. Rebound controlled by Schuwen. Put back goes down. And Quinnipiac seizes the lead once again. Half. Porter in the low block. Porter. Goes up and under with the right hand and finishes.
Huge
post up, she can handle the ball. She crosses over, looks to attack. Her runner off glass and good. What a terrific finish by the freshman. Then our daughter to Porter. Porter diagonal out to Welch. She'll take the three. And a big three by the freshman for Canisius. Front court, hands off to Martucci. Martucci in the paint. Her shot goes down. McClure, Strautmane in the block, goes up with the left hand and finishes. That's a tough matchup for Canisius down low to McClure. McClure looks to go baseline, spins. McClure goes up and puts it home, and now Quinnipiac is pulling away.
And a jump to block this shot, take it right to Crystal Porter.
Pass inside, laying it up and in. Margaret Halfdan, our daughter, with nine this afternoon. Miskovic with a steal against Martin. Miskovic looks to finish, and she'll go to the line to shoot two. Porter, McClure. Slashes inside and finishes for Quinnipiac. Rebound to Haunt for Canisius. Back to Miskovic. She drives and lays it up and in. Miskovic dribbles into pressure, swings to Cooley. She's open from three. Nothing but net for Sarah Cooley.
What matchup.
Napolitano to McClure. She'll take that 15-footer. Wow. She knocks it down. McClure looks to go. Kicks to the corner. Johnson from three. Rattles it home. Is the foul shot, and that will do it this afternoon at the Koessler Athletic Center. Quinnipiac, trailing most of this game, pulls away in the fourth quarter, and they'll win it by 12 this afternoon, their fourth straight win for Canisius. They have lost now six of the last seven.
And welcome back to the Koessler Athletic Center. Quinnipiac beating Canisius today here at the Koessler Athletic Center. All right, Coach Fabry, the game for the most part early on, Canisius looks like they were able to do what they wanted to do. What kind of adjustments did you want?
Well, Terry had his team playing today, losing Mills just 48 hours. And my goodness, they came in ready to play 60% in the first half. I don't even think we did that much better in the second half defending them. They were just playing with a lot of inspiration and they were making shots. They made us really work hard in the second half. We just kind of, we had to dig down and just find some way to get the ball. And I just think that it wasn't necessarily our defense. They just cooled off a little bit in the second half. We were able to still hang around and make some big plays offensively and get at the end of the third and then stretch it in the fourth.
Yeah, but talk about heart. Aryn McClure, your freshman, I mean, she really took over that game in the fourth quarter.
She was fantastic. I thought her and Paula really gave us a lift, and it was really nice to see Adelie Martucci for us had a big game for us as well. She had been struggling a little bit from the floor, so, but Aryn definitely spearheaded us and gave us a nice offensively, so that was really good to see. And, you know, we came up here, and it was really important for us to not only play well, but, you know, get a win, and anytime you can go on the road, and especially this Buffalo swing for us to get two big conference road wins, is really big for us going forward as we continue to grow and get better with this team.
And it really sounds like you're kind of enjoying the chase here a little bit after, of course, the team that was chased all last year. That being said, you know about what it takes to put together a championship team. You know this league's wide open this year. How do you feel about your chance forward?
Well, you know what? I'm just really pleased with our weekend's effort. You know, again, getting on the road, having not had we didn't win a conference game yet on the road, and be able to get on the road and get away with two wins out of up here in Buffalo. You know, it wasn't really pretty, but I'm really glad we were able to do it. Sorry, a lot of things running through my mind right now. But, you know, it was a really important weekend for us. And I think, you know, again, while we'd really, our identity has been a lot of defense, and we didn't really shut down Canisius today. I thought they played a great game. I'm really pleased that we were able to get these two wins and going forward and keep breeding a little confidence, and then seeing different players emerge and play better, and overall the team get the confidence and individual players get confidence, you know, mid-January. It's good to see this time of the year.
Congratulations, Coach.
Thank you.